Non-Pharmacologic Pain Management Strategies by Catherine Dowling.
Hi, my name is Catherine Dowling. I'm a nurse at Children's Hospital Boston in the cardiac ICU.
The objective of this presentation is to discuss non-pharmacological pain management strategies. Introduction.
Although we tend to focus on pharmacological mechanisms to control pain in the intensive care unit, there are non-pharmacologic techniques that can be very helpful in alleviating pain and encouraging coping in the pediatric patient. Parents should be involved in their child's pain management and should be taught to recognize the signs of pain. Oftentimes, the parent's presence is enough to calm the child and decrease their level of stress. The environment the patient is in should be kept as calm and relaxing as possible with minimal stimulation. Distraction techniques also work to decrease pain in the pediatric population. In the infant population, oral sucrose and cuddling with a parent have been shown to decrease the level of pain. Holistic therapies refer to caring for the whole patient, body, mind, and emotions. Therapies such as Reiki, massage, acupuncture, and acupressure can help with pain management.
Age-appropriate coping strategies.
Coping is what a person does in order to avoid, remove, minimize, or to get through a stressful situation. The age of the child will determine the best way to go about managing coping skills. Children at different developmental stages have different coping abilities. Younger children often worried about being separated from their parents, whereas school-aged children may be worried about waking up during the operation and experiencing pain.
Strategies for the infant.
Infants feel pain but do not express it in the same manner as older children or young adults. Studies indicate that the majority of parents do not know how to recognize the signs of infant pain. Excessive acoustic and visual stimuli in neonates should be avoided. Simple comfort measures such as swaddling, use of a pacifier, and positioning should be used for minor procedures. Oral administration of sucrose reduces pain associated with painful procedures. These interventions alone may not alleviate moderate to severe pain, and pharmacological treatment should be used as indicated.
Strategies for the toddler.
Sources of comfort for the toddler include parent presence, positioning, familiar objects such as a pacifier, blanket, and toys. The use of distraction is important to minimize the stress and anxiety of hospitalization and to strengthen the coping skills of the child.
Strategies for the preschool-aged child.
Hospitalization has the potential for being a very traumatic experience for children and their families. In the preschool population, parent presence, pre- and post-procedural play, positioning, distraction techniques, familiar objects, and music help the child to cope. Often, games or role-playing exercises are used to allow the child to express their concerns or emotions. This can give the staff and parents valuable information about a child's anxieties and misconceptions.
Strategies for the school-aged child.
In the school-aged population, parent presence still plays an important role in providing comfort. Pre- and post-procedural play, imagery, relaxation, and distraction enable the child to cope effectively with procedures. At Children's Hospital Boston, we have a pet therapy program which screens and trains dogs for bedside visits.
Strategies for the adolescent.
Detailed explanation of procedures is vital. Imagery, relaxation, and distraction techniques will help the adolescent cope more effectively.
Please help us improve the content by providing us with some feedback.